Today on Mike Attempts, repairing bolts with a thread file. In a future video, I'll be installing pie weights on my Ford tractor. But before I can do that, I'm going to attempt to repair the threads on these flange nut studs using a thread file. The bolt diameter doesn't matter. All you need to know is the threads per inch. If you're unsure, simply measure 1 inch on the bolt and count the number of threads. These have 18 threads per inch. This SAE thread file has 8 sizes. Metric files are also available, with sizes measured in threads per millimeter. I'll be using the number 18 file. All of the studs need some attention, but this one's the worst. I apologize for the malfunctioning autofocus. It clears up in just a minute. So, why not just buy a new bolt? If the store's open and it's a standard size, that's probably the best solution. In my case, I can't just walk into the store and buy these flange nut studs. And when you can find them online, they aren't cheap. All right. So, why not just run the appropriate size die over the threads? While that would work, a die often removes too much metal, which could result in weak threads. Okay, what about a thread chaser? A thread chaser would be perfect for this job. However, they're usually sold in kits that only repair standard sizes. It might be hard to find one for this stud diameter and thread pitch. A thread file does the same thing as a thread chaser, but the file is cheaper and can repair threads on a much wider variety of bolts, since diameter is not a factor. Be sure to stop periodically and run a nut over the threads. You don't want to remove any more metal than necessary, and the nut will help you determine which areas still need some work. After some more filing, I cleaned off the stud and the nut threads on with ease. Here's the before and after. By the end of the second stud, I had learned a few things. Number one. Wearing gloves makes the task much more comfortable and keeps your fingers from getting chewed up. Number two, if possible, start by using some of the good threads to help guide the file so that half the file rides on the good threads while the other half works on the bad threads. And number three, by using this filing technique, I only needed to flip the bolt once to get all the threads, making the process go much faster. It took some time and elbow grease, but they're all done. See the description below for a link to the thread file. Feel free to rate this video, add your comments and questions below, and subscribe for more.